Hello, everyone, and welcome to Cyclones TV. This is the voice of Tyler Holland, and I'll be taking you through this week's episode. To finish off the season, the Cyclones had four wins and four tough losses on the week. On Monday the 25th, the Cyclones suffered a tough loss as their bats were silenced, except for Michael Conforto, who went 3-for-5 and had an RBI. The very next day, the Cyclones had an offensive explosion led by Johan Ureña. He went 2-for-5 with a triple and drove in two runs. The Cyclones also had a stellar performance from starting pitcher Casey Meisner, who only gave up one run and allowed four hits and struck out 11 batters in six innings. Wednesday the 27th, we celebrated 90s night here at MCU Park. We also celebrated the walk-off hit-by-pitch victory by the Cyclones. Ahmed Rosario taking one for the team, so to speak. Aside from getting slimed, as you can see here, Michael Conforto also went 4-for-5. The Thursday through Saturday series with the Valley Cats proved to be fatal for the Cyclones as they were swept, and all of these games ended in a one-run loss. As a result, the Cyclones lost their two-game lead in the wild card race. On Sunday and Monday, the Cyclones would bounce back in a two-game home-and-home series against the Staten Island Yankees. Sunday night's game resulted in an offensive explosion as they would destroy Staten Island 11-3, sending their fans home happy after the last home game of the 2014 season. Heading into the final game of the season on Labor Day, the Cyclones needed a victory as well as a Lowell Spinners victory over the Connecticut Tigers. The Cyclones did their part as Casey Meisner pitched 5 shutout innings and only allowed 3 hits while striking out 3 in the 3-1 victory over the Staten Island Yankees. Shane Bay would close it out with his perfect 15-for-15 saves on the year. Cyclones couldn't get any help from the Spinners as they lost to the Connecticut Tigers 9-8, thus making the Connecticut Tigers the winner of the wild card race. But you know what they say.
There's no crying in baseball!
Thanks for that, Mr. Hanks. The Cyclones would finish the year with a 42-34 record, which keeps their 14-year streak alive of .500 baseball or better. They also led the league in attendance with 231,628. On behalf of the Brooklyn Cyclones and everyone here at Cyclones TV, thank you fans for another great summer of baseball. Let's move right along to the Player of the Week. This week's Player of the Week is catcher Adrian Abreu. The catcher, sometimes designated hitter, hit 3 doubles as well as a 3-run blast and collected 6 RBIs in the final 8 games of the season. Congratulations to the Player of the Week, Adrian Abreu. Now that you've seen the player, let's move on to the Plays of the Week. At number 5, we have a fly ball hit to left field for the diving, twinkle-toed Michael Conforto, making that play look simple. At number 4, we have a ball hit to Pedro Perez, and the ball actually deflects off of him, but JC Rodriguez is there for the bareheaded rebound. Shoot the J! Shoot it! And at number 3, we have Baldonado on the mound with the easiest double play you ever see. Ball hit back to him, he catches it, throws back to first. The stunned Staten Island Yankee doesn't know what to do. And at number 2, we have the 3-run blast from Adrian Abreu. It's gone so far that it actually destroys the Death Star, saving the galaxy from the evil empire. Slap hands, slap, slap, slap hands. And our top play comes from 90s night, a ball hit to Anthony Chavez, who says, "Hey, jealousy!" Great throw to first, and that play was all that. And that's all we have for this week's Cyclones TV. Be on the lookout for a special 2014 season and review episode.